I'm very happy to be here to present this workshop. And it's like the workshop will be about acupressure for pain relieving labor. I just want to introduce myself briefly. I'm a midwife, an independent midwife. I used to work in London as a community midwife. And then now I'm just concentrating more in I'm an acupuncturist and teaching acupressure to Italian midwives. Actually, I've been teaching internationally. I use a lot of acupressure within my practice, and I really recommend it. I suggest that you start using it. It's a very good technique. Yourself more autonomy. First of all, I would like to acknowledge Deborah Beth, which has been for me a great inspiration. She's acupuncturist. She's been teaching acupressure all over the world, in Italy as well, and she's teaching in New Zealand acupuncture for midwives in a short course. I think I really suggest that you look into her website, which is Acupuncture Resource Zone, because you can get a lot of leaflets, a lot of material. She's very happy to share with all the midwives. So go into her website and you'll get a lot of information. Before we start talking about Chinese medicine, about the theory of Chinese medicine, about acupressure, we need to go a little bit about the theory of Chinese medicine. The only thing I will be talking is like what is qi and what are the meridian. Qi is a basic concept on Chinese medicine, can be translated as energy, life force, the energetic form of the vapor. And it's actually you cannot see this vapor, this energy, but it's actually got a lot of power, such as the one such as lifting the lid off the pot. Qi flow to the channel, which I call channel or meridian, which are like a river, a network of river that travel our entire body, connect to our main organ. It will nourish our organs, make sure they will function well. In good health, qi moves smoothly through the channel. However, if you got excess or deficiency or blockage of qi, might cause pain and illness. If you think about labor, emotions such as fear, anger, and frustration, which are quite common in labor, this can make the pain worse. In traditional Chinese medicine, and I strongly believe in this, mind and body is related. If you are tense, if you are anxious about your welfare, your energy will block and you feel more pain. So acupressure is used as an unblocking technique to make the qi to restore harmony and to make the qi flow smoothly. And thus the woman will feel less the pain. This is an important concept. I'm simplifying this, but it's just like it's the basic. We can call Chinese medicine is energetic medicine. What is acupressure? Acupressure is acupressure pressure. I need to stress that it's not a massage, it's actually a pressure to acupuncture point. The same point you are along the channel, which are used in acupressure. What are the advantages of acupressure? We do have a lot of advantages. First of all, it's not an invasive technique. It's very easy to use and it's safe. There's been a lot of research that says it is safe. More choice for women. This is very important. Women can have more choice. A lot of women now want to avoid pharmacological pain relieving labor. We know that gabapentin or epidural can have some side effect. So this is something it's very important. More choice. Promote birthing partner involvement in a way that a lot of the time in labor partner, they don't really know what to do. They feel like they're useless. So if they learn the point before labor, then when arrive in labor world, they are happy to use. They really feel that they can do something for a woman. This is the same if you go like a support people, not necessarily to the partner. Everybody, the woman can choose to have a labor, can sort of using acupressure, feeling involved with the whole procedure. What it does, it empowers women as well, because at some point, women can self-initiate acupressure. So they can feel that they can do something for themselves. They don't have to delegate their health to other people. As well, I believe that it increases midwife autonomy. Since I've been using acupressure, I feel I can have more things to offer to women, which are very simple. Or just to give an example, before some time you wait in the women, they can have an epidural, you can start using the point and mean that she feel more relaxed. And then she can still have an epidural, but at least you felt that you've done something to help her. Another advantage of acupressure, which I strongly believe, is that it can be used in water and they can mobilize it. If you use acupuncture, I know it's a very good therapeutic tool. However, you have to stay still. You can't really move, and I strongly believe that moving around in labor will help you continue with the pain. And another important aspect is reduce the medicalization of childbirth. As I said before, to reduce the use of drug in labor, there's been some studies that show reduce the use of pharmacological pain relief, and as well. It will help for acupressure can be used for inducing and preparation labor. There's been some research which seemed to reduce the use of medical use of syntocinon if you use acupressure. What are the evidence? There are quite a few evidence. The most recent one is the 2000 in the Cochrane Review, Smith et al., which they say the use of acupressure was associated with a reduction in pain intensity in labor. And this was a comparative study because they compare the use of acupressure using pain relief, the point used for pain relief, with sham acupressure, which are the point that they're using acupressure point but not used for pain relief in labor. They actually seen that. Is seen the reduced rectal cesarean section when compared to sham acupression. So basically, not only to reduce the pain intensity, but to reduce this need of cesarean section. And then there's another study, the Levitt et al., 2016, reported acupression significantly reduced the need for epidural and cesarean section, as well seemed to reduce the need of pain relief in labor. Adverse about safety. I think there is only more minor effect that can be like bruising, pain, or discomfort in the area. However, only if you use this with too much pressure. So you need to be careful to adapt the pressure to the woman level. You need to be painful. And as well, there's been no clinical, there's been no report. I've been using a lot and I've been teaching a lot, as I say, in Italy, acupressure and midwife are using it. A lot, and I don't clinical there's been any problem with premature labor or fetal distress in labor. As long, which is very important, that you don't use those points, which I'm going to tell you, before 37 weeks, like bladder 32, bladder 60, gallbladder 21, and large intestine 4. These points are more point for inducing labor, so hopefully you shouldn't start before them, and you need to be careful starting too early even for induced labor. Acupressure, and now the mechanism, a little bit about the mechanism of pain relief in labor. There's been few hypotheses. It's not like a blocking pain. It's not like an epidural that you completely take away the pain. I mean, not always, sometimes it doesn't work. However, it will stimulate the body to work more effectively, reduce less pain. If you're thinking about what I said before, it will help the chi move freely. Smoothly into the body. This will result in less pain because anytime you go like a blockage of the energy, the chi circulation to the meridian, you feel more pain. So this is one important mechanism about the acupressure. They think a certain point affect the area of the brain known to reduce sensitivity to the pain and stress. And what is more important, seem to increase endorphin. We all know that endorphins are a good natural pain relief, which will promote relaxation, physical and emotional well-being. As well, which is very important, I think, from the midwifery point of view, apply pressure to the acupressure point because it will include touch. You feel like you're supporting the women, and the touch it actually increases the production of oxytocin. Oxytocin is a hormone level which is really like is very helpful because it helps the woman to relax, calming. She will cope better with the pain. So oxytocin is a whole, we call love hormone. The woman will more in control the situation. So this is a very important aspect. Going about the practicality, I believe that what I've been doing, as I say, I've been teaching to a lot of midwives in Italy. They've been already started introducing in labor, and particularly they're using on in the antenatal classes. Sometimes half an hour section, particularly when the pattern is there, is very useful. I tend to give a lot of information about, you can download the one in the Deborah Beth. She's very happy to share the information. So you can, they found out if you give some leaflet, particularly the man, the partner, will it's easy for them to follow, because it's very important that they know, if they know the point beforehand, they will, when the woman in labor, they know it will be better for them to use it, for the support people to use the point. You need to give it by the woman feedback. The woman, she's going to tell you which point she prefers in a way. It's like I said before, it's a pressure, it's not a massage. You need to be at the woman's comfort level, not too strong. Probably you can start gently and then increase. Showing the point, I think it might be a question, showing the point in the antenatal classes, it can be, as I said before, there's some point that you have to avoid. You need to be gentle. They got a leaflet, they know where the point is. You need to do gently, avoid any problem, okay? The pressure and point the woman find most useful like to change and label progress. And we discuss as you that show your clinical scenario after which can explain this. The point can change. There are some points which are better to use in early label, at some point they're used better to use on transition or on the second stage of label. However, if you are trying all the points with women consent, obviously, but the woman feels that she's not coping with the pain and she wants some more pain relief. Epidural can still an option. She can have a choice to have an epidural. However, as I said before, you can start carry on using the point relaxing her while she's waiting for an epidural. The first point now we are going to discuss with the first point for pain relief is gallbladder 21. Gallbladder 21 is on the gallbladder meridian. It's the most tender point along pathway between C7 and tip of shoulder point, which is called the acromion process. It's at the top of the trapezium muscle. The technique, the gallbladder technique, you need to apply firm downward pressure using knuckles or elbow. I suggest you start gently and then you increase the pressure to tolerance, because this can be a very sensitive point. You can apply the pressure at the beginning of the contraction, or you do gentle pressure, which is very relaxing, which is intensive, then intensify the pressure while she's got the contraction. Okay. The clinical, the implication of why is working gallbladder 21 for pain relief. It's got a very good, it's benefit the tendon and muscle. It's a very relaxing point. And it's obviously, like I said before, the more the woman relaxes, the more she will cope with the pain, better she will cope with the pain. And as a strong downward movement, that's for this reason, is a very, from feedback I got from the from my clinical practice, I noticed this point is very good in the second stage when the head can be very high. And then because of that, she doesn't feel the urge to push. Obviously, the second stage will last longer. So by using this point, as I say, it's got a very downward movement. It brings the chi down, basically. The woman will feel that she feels more the urge to push. And she will cope better with the pain. And then there is another point. She's bladder 32. As I mentioned, she's on, is on the bladder meridian. I say it again, all these points are bilateral, okay? The location is over the second sacrum foramen, and it's actually, you need to be careful not going to, you can have a sharp sensation if you are on the bone, okay? So the technique you apply, you can apply firm pressure by placing knuckles into the body. What I do in practice, I can use the counteraction where the woman is contracted, I ask the woman to come towards me and I actually use my knuckles and to press into the point. And this is more effective. Once she's contracting, you can use the counteraction. Another way you can use this point, the woman can use if she's alone, and it's a very good point for her in labor. If she's alone, she can use like a tennis ball against the wall to lean back into doing a contraction, okay? Feedback from women and from my clinical practice is a very effective point. It can cause anesthetic effect. In fact, I had in one clinical scenario when I stopped using it because I was on my break. I stopped using the woman really, I had a talk with her after she felt that she really missed that point. So that is a very good for pain relief. It's very good as well if you got backache, which generally women in labor tend to have a backache, especially in early labor. I just want to show a clinical scenario report, a clinical scenario, which is one of my just had a recent water birth using acupressure. I think it was like a primigravida, was a planned home birth. In early labor, I started using acupressure on bladder 31. The woman was coping well with the pain, at the point produced anesthetic, good anesthetic effect. However, on the second stage, I just noticed that the head was not descending. So I started using gallbladder 21. And I felt that the woman was pushing more effectively, and that she was better at this point, at this on the second stage, was better use gallbladder 21 than using the bladder 31. As I say before, gallbladder has got strong downward movement, allowing the head to descend, contributed to reducing pain as it shortened the second stage of labor. In this scenario, after half an hour, I was still using gallbladder 21. She had a beautiful delivery. Second stage, it was lasted in total 1 hour. So this is to explain that sometimes you need to move, change point. And as I say, gallbladder 21 is very good on the second stage. If you will help, it's got a very good descending property, will help to head to descend. Another point that the woman, this point she can use for herself, is large intestine 4. It's on the large intestine meridian, is bilateral. It's on the dorsum of the hand between the first and second metatarsal bone, at the midpoint of the second metatarsal bone. It's a very sensitive point. Okay, this is a good, got a very, and it's very good for any sort of pain relief, if you go like backache, headache. Okay, in labor, it's just you need to apply firm pressure with thumbs. As I say, the woman can do this for herself, which is very good, it will empower her. It is a very energetic point as it tonifies chi. I found that this point is very good to use when the woman is tired. I use it like on transition. She will build her own energy ready for the second stage when she needs. And then we got another point, which is kidney one. The location of kidney one in depression found in the top third of the sole of the foot. You need to apply strong pressure inward and upward towards the big toes. What kidney one does, it will help to deal with fear. We mentioned before that any sort of emotion can actually stop the leg, can blockage the chi, the energy, so that when you get stuck. So it's used for panic issue, calming the mind. This point is a user for relaxation action. This point can be used when women arrive in labor, which are they are in a new environment, they can feel they are stressed, they got fear, they will feel, or they don't know what's happened to them. So I tend to use this point at this moment when they arrive in labor. However, it's a point that can be used all the time in labor, particularly when the woman is losing control. And it will help her to get down to the head, just get eradicated into the head. I think one way we can use kidney one is actually apply seasickness band with a button, apply pressure to kidney one. Or you can suggest the woman to use a pumpkin or sesame seed on a plastic tape. And then she can mobilize in walking. Women move around in early labor and then squat in the second stage. This is a very important point to say is relaxing. And she can use all the time in labor. It is a safe point to use in pregnancy as well. It's not a contraindication in pregnancy. Another useful point is like to have combs where you can place tifo combs along palm of hand where finger join palm. Apparently, they've seen some research doing that. This seems to some endorphin point along the palm. Which is very good for pain relief, obviously. You need to tell women I just found that in Italy there was a case once a woman arriving there using combs. A pap is being using for many times, starting using in Russia. So women, when they got this pain, when they got the contraction, they can grip the combs during contraction as required. The last point is bladder 60 on the bladder meridian, is bilateral. is on the lateral side of the ankle, midway between the high point of the highest point of the lateral malleolus and the Achilles tendons. This point is chosen for pain relief in labor, particularly is very good near transition. And as well as a gallbladder 21 is a point that will help the baby side to descend. So it's a very effective point. And it seems as well in instance study, the SINTA is good for changing position. If you got a baby which is on the posterior position, you would like to change the position. This is a very energetic point. In conclusion, really, I just wanted to show you a video, which is regarding kidney one. This is actually a water birth I just had recently. And I used kidney one in labor, which was very at the beginning of labor, because I noticed with this woman, which is, this is her second baby, I delivered her first baby as well, so I know her. She was so scared about the pain, the previous pain of the labor. She had a very good labor last time as well. However, the pain was, she couldn't let her go, basically, because of the pain. So I used, you can see that the technique, you can use like a circulated motion, you can use this as well. And it's very, as I said, it really, I used for about half an hour, and then really the contraction started, and she used the water bath, she had a beautiful water bath. I used gallbladder 21 for pain relief, and bladder 32. Particularly, I used gallbladder 21 because the head was very high at the beginning, at the second stage. So she just used that. But particularly, I just wanted to stress the importance of using kidney one for relaxing any sort of fear in labor, which a lot of the time women can have a fear of pain, or they might have a traumatic effect, traumatic birth with the previous birth. Was not the case with this woman, but you know, just try to remember to use kidney one when there is any issue of fear. In conclusion, I just think that it's a very acupressure is a very good tool, and what I really recommend is that you can start using as soon as possible. Obviously, you need to ask the women consent. For my experience, a lot of the women they like it. Because we can give them something, an extra choice, as I said before, more choice. And obviously it's safe. And if you women don't want it, just don't use it. There is no, as I say, contraindication. I just recommend you to use it and then you can see the results, which are very good. I hope that this is just an introduction, obviously, regarding acupressure. Because acupressure, as I mentioned before, it can be used for preparation labor, induction labor, for many, for other things, a change of position, and there is a posterior position. So I really recommend that you start. I mean, I really hope that I have let you wanted to learn more about acupressure. But as I say, just use it. Thank you for listening. I'm open to all questions that you might have. Okay, thank you.